morning, everyone. I'm glad you made it again. This is Sober Dope Fix number 14. And it is fantastic that you're continuing to do this process. I hope you feel good, just the fact that you showed up. So let's get started. We're gonna take literally 1 minute. If a prayer is your thing, now is the time to say a prayer. Repeat it several times if you want to. Now is the time to check in with yourself. Now is the time to think about your intentions. Take some deep breaths. Allow yourself to start waking up to the morning. Think about your intentions. Who are you becoming? And let's begin. For 1 minute, here we go. Okay, please stand. Now it's time to prime our body. Priming ourselves mind, body, and spirit. We're gonna take 10 minutes to get ourselves a little more awakened into our bodies. Here we go, for 10 minutes. Take a deep breath in and out. Breathe in and out. Notice if you feel any shift in that. Hands up for breath of fire. Ready, set, and go. Good. Breathe comfortably, walk around, start to move your hands, shake your shoulders, shake your feet a little, even smile at yourself for a moment. You are alive. It could definitely be otherwise. Good morning. All right, hands up, ready, set, and begin. Good. Again, walk forward a little bit. Move your feet around. Shake your legs a little. Shake your shoulders. Roll your shoulders a little. Move your head a little side to side. Open your jaw. Close your jaw. Allow the blood to start to circulate. All right, one last time. Hands up. Ready, set, and go. Good. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Breath in and exhale. Good. Notice how that feels. That's about 2 minutes of just focused breathing. It can make all the difference in the world. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, hands out to the side, fingertips back towards your ears, palms pushing out at the same time. Bend your knees slightly. Take a deep breath, shoulders to your ears, and exhale. One more time, hands up, and shoulders down. One more time, shoulders up and hold, and exhale. Palm, fingertips now facing down. Good. And back up. Take a deep breath. Exhale, palms to your sternum. Palms together, thumbs to your sternum. See if you can feel your heartbeat. See if you can slowly feel yourself coming alive. Mornings tend to be the most anxious and depressed times of our day. Not always, but it's a tendency. So knowing how to cultivate your own medicine, to shift your chemistry, to begin to build your energy, is a fantastic way to start your day. Take a deep breath. Palms to your ears. Look up to the sky, up on your toes. Exhale and stretch and stretch. Go for it. Feel it all the way into your belly, all the way down your side waist. One side higher than the other, one arm higher than the other. Start to move your hands around, twinkling your fingers, flicking your fingers out. Palms to the ceiling, raise the roof. Top of the hands to the ceiling. Stretch up on your toes as high as you can go. Come on. You can do it. Take a deep breath. Come down on your heels, all weight in your heels. Exhale, bending from the waist. Bend your knees, fingertips on the ground. All weight on your heels. Relax your head, relax your neck, relax your jaw. Rest your belly on your thighs. Breathe. Deep breath into your lower back. Exhale, sink down closer to the ground. Good. Exhale. Breathe deep again. Inhale and exhale. Sink closer to the ground. Bend your knees. Put your hands flat on the ground. Walk your hands forward. Come into a pre-plank position. And on your marks, get set and go. It's plank time. We got 2 minutes. All weight is in your toes and your forearms. Mostly your elbows. Bring your belly button up towards your spine. Good. Relax. Continue to breathe. We've been talking a lot about our negativity bias. Take a moment to think about how often you've been having negative thoughts, especially this morning. That is a choice of yours. And if it's not a choice that you're consciously making, it's an unconscious choice. So choose to think about where your thoughts go. This is your mind. As Viktor Frankl said, the famous author of Man's Search for Meaning that chronicles his experience in the Holocaust, he said, between stimulus and response, there is a space. Between any stimulus and response, there is a space. And in that space, there is a choice. And in that choice is your power, your growth, and your freedom. Your ability to be conscious and to choose how you respond to what life brings to you is where you will find your power, your growth, and your freedom. Choose. We have 30 seconds left. Keep breathing, belly button up to your spine. Keep your back flat, elbows and toes. If you need to come down for a moment to break, that's okay. Continue to choose. This is your opportunity to grow. When life brings you challenges, negative thoughts, do you want to keep feeding those negative thoughts and keep going with them? Choose. Learn how to focus your thoughts. It's partly what the two-will practice is for. Come down to your knees. Good job, you guys. Sit back on your heels. Hands up into a diamond or a triangle. Put that flat on the ground. I put your forehead right on in there. Good. Breathe deeply into your lower back. One more time. Deep breath. Good. And relax. And you're going to come up. You're going to turn back and sit back on your bottom. And raise your feet slightly. Point your toes. Rock back. Chin to your chest. Hands out. And we're going to do the hundreds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8, 9, 50, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 60, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 100. Excellent. Come back to a plank. Good. 5 push-ups, just like this. Ready? 5 push-ups. Here we go. Slowly. And down. And then up. Breathe. Down. And up. That's 2. Down. And up. Down. And up. 1 more. Down. And up. Downward facing dog. Breathe. Take a deep breath. Inhale. Upward facing dog. Stretch out your abs. Good. Come back to a plank. Exhale. Walk your hands forward. Shift all your weight back on your heels. Fingertips on the ground. Relax. All weight on your heels, fingertips on the ground, knees bent. Take a deep breath. And begin to straighten your legs. Good. Breathe. Straightening your legs, all weight in your heels, fingertips on the ground. Take a deep breath. And begin to slowly come up. And when you get to the top, roll shoulders back. 5 times in a fluid motion. Good. Shake your feet. Shake your legs. Shake your hips. Shake your shoulders. Shake your arms. Shake your face. Good. Take a deep breath in. Exhale out. Fingertips back towards your ears. Palms pushing out. Bend your knees slightly. Good. Palms together. Thumbs to your sternum. See if you can feel your heart rate. Notice any difference. Excellent. That was 10 minutes. Notice how you feel. We're only about 11 minutes into this whole program. Notice if you see or feel any shift in how you are thinking, how your emotions feel, etc., etc. All right, please have a seat. Please pull out your journal, review the two-wheel practice. You're either focused, or you're practicing the technique for 180 seconds. Now you're focusing your mind. This is about learning how to recover from distraction. Harvard did a study, I don't know how they do these studies. They did a study, they found that the number one attribute that someone needs to succeed at almost any endeavor is the ability to focus. That's deep. You need to know that you can focus when you need to. And if you do get distracted, learning to recover from your distraction efficiently and consistently. All right, so for 180 seconds, we're gonna practice the two-wheel practice. Please get into the posture. You should know this posture by now. You ready? And begin. over and over, come back to your focus. Allow your distraction to be an opportunity to deepen your focus. Just come back over and over. No judgment. Just allow it. Excellent. Notice where your thoughts went. Notice where you were distracted. That is vital. You have to learn to know your own mind. Learn to tame it. Hands up for 30. Ready, set, and go. Good. Please pull out your journals. Please put the date on this page. For 5 minutes, this is a time for honest self-reflection. Just a reminder, when you write your goals of the day, review where you missed yesterday, but also write down where you succeeded in your goals. All right, and how did you succeed? And make sure you're writing your emotional and mental relapse and what you're doing about that. Here we go. You should finish early. Please do push-ups and some sit-ups and some squats. You can do squats without weights. It's very good for you, actually. And again, if you do finish early, knock out 5 push-ups. Do some squats. Do a few sit-ups. Continue to take care of your body. Do some stretching. Excuse me. Thank you. We got some good folks streaming here. They wished me a God bless you. We got a little less than a minute left. Okay, excellent. Let's do 12 push-ups. Ready, get set, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Excellent. All right, come back to your seat. And now we're gonna do the question of the day. It's an opportunity to get very honest with yourself. So, if you're using this as a time marker, that's okay. But for those of you who are keeping this sequential, which I do recommend, number 14. What is the most important moment of your life? This one. How will you remember that and so you are not overly ruminative? As I say, if you're focused in the future, anxiety. Past, often depression. How are you going to stay present? Your power is in the present. There's no power in the future or in the past. Only here is reality. How are you going to stay here in reality? What is your technique? What are your skills? What is your commitment? For 180 seconds, write about that. What is your commitment to yourself to live here in life? All right, please begin. Finish early, as usual. Do a little stretching. Use this time. So for some of you who are new to this idea of learning to stay present, I encourage you, try setting your alarm on your phone. You know, at every 20 minutes after the hour, every 15 minutes after the hour, your alarm goes off to remind you, hey, come back. Continue to return to the present. Stay here. A lot of us have learned to stay emotionally healthy by checking out. And that's understandable. And that worked. Maybe that's worked for a while. But the question is that working anymore? All right. Please take a moment. Review your gratitude list. Review your goals of the day. Look at what you're going to do about your signs of emotional and mental relapse. I just want to say you cannot show up and do this morning routine without at least a little bit of love for yourself. And I am very, it's odd to say, that I'm proud of you for seeing and following through on that love for yourself. And you're looking to build and grow that love. I really believe that. By showing up to this, you are looking to build that love. That's a beautiful thing. So, I'll see you next time.